Raise your hand if you tried to cut your hair and it went horribly wrong. I'm raising my hand, by the way.
Check that out on Instagram.
Sarah with an H.
Yeah, Sarah had a malfunctioning with the scissors and she hacked her hair. But, you know.
And they're uneven.
How's it going, everyone? We are making a video today. The last video we actually made was announcing the official Olympic roster for the Olympic Games. And that was exciting.
It truly was.
Yeah. Check that out. I'm sure everyone knows the Olympic team now. Actually, they just announced the gymnastics Olympic team, too. So that was also quite fun.
We are a gymnastics channel, so
we
that would make sense.
We should. That'd be fun. So what we're going to do today, we're going to kind of talk about a couple different things. It's a Tobin and Christen video. What can I say?
Yeah.
We're going to kind of talk about three different kind of things. One, we're going to talk about them both being selected for the Olympics. We're also going to talk about they did an event for Reinc, and we're going to talk about that. And then we're also going to talk about that they have officially left Man United, official. So we'll talk about that a little bit. So first, let's talk about the Olympic squad. They named the 18-person roster for all-person alternate squad. I don't think there was any doubt about Christen being picked. There was
100%.
She was one of the very first people that they were going to select. And, you know, there was kind of that question about Tobin for a little bit. But in my last video, we kind of talked about I never thought they weren't going to include Tobin. There's always a possibility she could re-injure herself or not.
Let's hope that I'm knocking on wood.
But they were both selected. And, you know, let's talk about that for a second. You know, you're selected with your partner and going to the Olympics. This is technically the second time they'll go to the Olympics together. Tobin's been four times. That's wild. Four times. And this is Kristen's second time going, but this is their second time going together. But I know this time it actually feels different, maybe even more special in some ways, maybe because Christen is playing so outstanding. But, you know, as we all know, the last Olympic game they played in, it did not go well. They were eliminated in the quarterfinals. So, you know, it's special that they're both there. I think if Tobin wasn't selected and Christen was going, I think obviously Tobin would have been supporting Christen nonstop and the whole team.
Mm-hmm.
But just to go experience those things together as partners. Because we remember when Jordan wasn't selected for Team GB, Leah specifically said, "I'm gutted for Jordan. I'm completely gutted."
Yeah.
I guess it's a little different because Tobin would have had an injury, so that's pretty much the reason why she wouldn't have gone. So, Tobin has an Olympic gold medal. You know what? She actually has two Olympic gold medals. Christen has no Olympic medal. So,
that's wild.
This is the competition where Christen hopefully earns her Olympic medal. Hopefully gold. I mean, that's the goal, the hope and the dream. So, this is the competition where Christen earns her Olympic medal, hopefully gold.
Yeah, they got to make it happen.
Yeah. And I mean, I think we've talked about it. In the soccer world, World Cup's number one. You know, for people who play the Euros, Euros maybe number two. But the Olympics, we keep talking about this, to be an Olympian, to have an Olympic gold medal, anywhere you go in the world, you know what Olympic gold medal represents. Because I even think in America, we know what Olympic gold medal means more than a World Cup first because we're not a soccer country. It's almost like, don't you agree? You know, a lot of people, I would say go up to 100 people on the street. Maybe 70% might know what the World Cup is. I don't think 100% would know. Maybe 65, don't you agree? Like 70.
Yeah.
I think a lot would. Maybe even less than that.
We're talking the U.S.?
Yeah, in the U.S., in the U.S.
Yeah.
But you go up to any person on the street and you say, do you know what Olympic gold medal is? I would say 98% of people would say yes.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, they know what Olympic gold medals mean.
Bring up the stats.
Yeah, I know. Those are completely off my head. But especially in America, I know every other country is probably different. Of course, you know the World Cup. But a lot of other countries, America doesn't really know much about the World Cup overall.
Unless you follow soccer.
Unless you follow soccer.
A lot of people do.
Or unless you're like a very like casual sports fan.
But everybody knows what the World Cup is.
See, I don't think so.
They just don't know what it means.
Good point. Okay. I like that point. So hopefully they get their Olympic medal together. That will be special, you know, special for the Olympics. Again, no spectators there, you know, and it's hard because you want to win in front of your family, but it's not, as long as they can watch on the TV, you know, it's something. There'll be a Japanese fans though, which will be nice.
Yeah.
But no.
So they'll be rooting him on.
And there is a little bit of a controversy. Tell me if anyone's heard of this too. Apparently, moms are not allowed to bring their children. So even breastfeeding moms and moms aren't allowed to bring their children.
Is that children.
Because of COVID? Because of COVID, and Japan has made that official rule. What they've said is breastfeeding moms and things like that might be allowed a case-per-case basis. But Serena Williams, whose daughter I think is 3 or 4, Serena Williams specifically said, I can't bring my daughter, therefore, one of the reasons I'm not going to go.
Oh, I did hear that.
Yeah. So someone like Alex Morgan.
So Alex can't bring her baby?
Right now, the official rule is no. But it's a case-per-case basis where they're going to allow certain moms to bring their kids.
Are they trying to protect the babies and the moms?
Or the baby, they want to limit the amount of people who come in the country. What they're saying is even if you have a baby, you have to bring a guardian for that baby. So it's not just one person. An extra 2 people. And if they have to award every Olympic, it has to be fair. Like, so even people from America, or if you're a French athlete, or if you're an athlete from, you know,
The Alps,
you know, Switzerland, they want it to be fair. So they're just making it case by case basis. So tell me if you've heard that. Okay. Oh, and I guess since we're talking about that right now, we'll talk about this. Tobin Heath apparently will not be wearing number 17 for the Olympics. I mean, the numbers could be swapped on accident on the website, but maybe not. So it could be an accident. But as of right now, Tobin Heath, is 7 and Abby is 17, even though they've swapped numbers. But yeah.
Whoa.
So
the numbers go up to 18, correct?
It looks like that. Yeah, they go up to 18. So 1 to 18.
Who's 17?
Abby Dahlkemper. So Abby Dahlkemper will be wearing number 17.
You know, she kind of looks like a 17.
She does. Yeah, I could totally see her 17. And then, so it looks like they've just switched around a few numbers based on only having 18. They're only going to 1 to 18. And then, like, Christen Press can't have number 23 because they don't go to 23. But it looks like, and then Kelly O'Hara is always 5. She has 5. So
who's 10?
Okay, Carly's 10. She's always 10, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Abby will be the official number 17, it looks like. And then Tobin is going to be number 7. So
it's half of 17.
Yeah, it has a 7 in there. So is that going to make, you know, sports athletes are very superstitious.
Yes, but they're going to have to make do with
what they get. As long as she has a 7 on her uniform, because she was 77 at Man United, 7 now.
There you go.
That's a perfect number for her. The other thing we are going to talk about is, I don't know, this happened, and we just kind of talked about it because we thought it was so beautiful. Tobin and Christen, as everyone knows, has their company Reinc with Megan Rapinoe, Megan Kliegenberg, and they run the company. And so they have Reinc on Instagram. First of all, did you see Christen did a takeover for Reinc that day?
I did. I saw. Yeah. Was it 1 day or 2 days?
It was like a day and a half, or like maybe two days.
Okay. I saw the first day.
Yeah. I saw the first day, and it was so cute. She had like got up in the morning. She was like, this is what I'm doing. And her and Tobin look like they're training. Looks like they're training. Mm-hmm. I'm not exactly sure where. So they did the takeover. Super cute. I saw the videos, and you could kind of see, like, it looked like Tobin was a photographer for the day. I mean,
oh yeah,
it kind of looked like that. They're having fun. So kind of along with that, the next day after Christen did the Reinc takeover, they had an in-store like meet and greet. Someone had DM'd us saying, hey, are you guys going to the meet and greet, or did you hear about the meet and greet?
Where's that, California?
Yeah, it was in California, in Southern California. And I hadn't even heard about it because me and Sarah have been busy packing.
I heard about it.
You heard about it?
I've been on the socials.
Yeah, sometimes. I haven't been as much. So they had a meet and greet, and I will say this, I don't know if it was just for Reinc members, and I don't exactly know how it went, or if you had to buy something, or, you know, but it was for...
Let us know if you went.
Yeah, let us know if you went. It was outside. And Tobin and Christen were meeting fans, and they personally signed for like the first 60 people. Whoa. And met the first 60 people. And so I'll play some of the video in the background. But
what did they do after 60?
I don't know. Maybe they
take a photo with them.
Maybe they just got an autograph and they weren't able to meet them. Something like that. I'm not exactly sure. It was at a place called Bodega LA. Apparently, Bodega is selling some of the Reinc brand merch at the store. So they're selling some of it there. So to meet Tobin and Christen, I read that they had all the people meeting them had to show their vaccination card, their vaccine card.
Nice.
I know. And they're saying they wanted to be safe, but also they have to keep safe for the Olympics. You know, it's not just, it's not just want to keep being safe. So they had to show the vaccination card.
I like that.
We watched some of the videos of them being there. So super cute. There was one point where they were sharing watermelon. And they were, did you see that, Sarah? They were sharing their watermelon.
Yeah.
So cute. So California. And just meeting people. Kristen's sisters were there. And like a very like positive event, you know what I mean? Positive. You know, and it was so cute, them sitting next to each other. I mean, they both looked amazing.
Yeah, they look good.
They look so good. They're both sitting next to each other, and if you watch some of the videos, I mean, Christen just radiates this energy, like so appreciative of people coming down to meet them, and you know, and it support the brand, because from what I know about the brand, it's very successful. It's, you know, they are smashing the sustainable clothing game, you know what I mean? So did you guys check out, see those pictures from Bodega? That was really cool. And so cool, you know, especially not being able to meet fans for so long. Even at the games, they're still not able to really go up to people and kind of shake hands and look at people, because
yeah, so that was cool that they did that.
And you know, I'm glad that their company's doing so well. The I guess the very last thing is super quick, but Man United officially said goodbye to Tobin and Christen. They officially are not going to be playing there, and they announced it on their Instagram. Whoa. So that, you know, that's interesting. You know, we kind of think, what's next? Are they going to play for Louisville? Are they going to wait for the expansion draft to see where they go?
Who knows?
I don't think many people think they're going to be playing for Louisville. I think most people say no. There's a lot of people who want them to, though.
I know. They should shuck the world and just come out in uniform and those flowers.
Do the unexpected. Yeah, yeah. Because we know that there's going to be the Olympics. And usually after the Olympics, they do friendlies or international games after the Olympics. So my question is, are they going to be unattached until next year? I think two things. I think, you know, they're only going to play for another few years, probably, you know, 3 years.
Don't say that.
Don't you want to play as much as you can? But B, if they really don't want to play, they shouldn't be playing somewhere where they really don't want to be playing, for whatever reason. It could just That's be because true. It could be for not because they don't like Louisville. I mean, nothing like that. But the other thing is, I always hear that the national team coach, even though they're not allocated players, the national team coach wants the people on the national team to be playing somewhere. I always hear that. They want to be playing somewhere.
Right.
So will there be any pressure to say, hey, I don't care where you play, we just want to see you playing somewhere.
You just gotta play.
Because some leagues, some countries tell their players, if you're not playing club somewhere, you're not going to be on the national team.
Makes sense.
Are they just going to wait? I know Christen wants to play in L.A. just for being a native person from Los Angeles. She's a native Los Angelan.
Did you see someone had a button or something that said something about
CPLA or something?
Yeah.
Christen Press L.A. Yeah. It's like a whole, like, it's a whole thing. It's like a whole thing they have.
Oh, yeah.
So I did see that. So, but someone said, well, would they want to go to San Diego? And I'm almost positive Christen wouldn't want to play in San Diego, because A, she'd rather be in L.A., but B, if Jill Ellis is attached to the San Diego team, I always got the feeling like Jill Ellis and Christen, they respected each other, but, you know, Jill Ellis didn't give Christen the playing time a lot of people deserved, or the chances a lot of people thought Christen Press deserved when Jill Ellis was there. I don't think she would want to go to San Diego, but Casey Stoney is going to possibly be there. And if they like Casey Stoney, I could see them in San Diego. But I see Christen Press wanting to play in LA. I actually see Tobin Heath possibly wanting to play in San Diego, which would, I think, would be perfect. They're living the same, but 2 hours away.
Yeah, not bad.
Or I could see them both with LA, or I could see them, I could see them both in San Diego. But officially, Manchester United are no longer playing there. We'll see where they end up. And I guess the expansion draft isn't till December. So does that mean if they're waiting all the way till December, they're not going to play any club games until December? Maybe. You know?
No, I want them to play somewhere.
Me too. What did you guys think? So yeah, excited for them to be at the Olympics together. That Bodega event was
lit.
So happy for them. It seemed like such a positive event, and so nice to see Kristen's sisters. If I see the picture of Kristen's sisters, I'll put that up. But her sister's there, you know. It looks so positive. And then Tobin and Christen officially are not with Man United anymore. What do you guys think?
Yeah, thoughts.
Thoughts. Yeah, so the last couple of videos, I have read every comment. I just, my responding game is just the next 2 weeks. I probably.
Y'all know we're moving. We're moving. So it's about to get wild. Yeah.
Once we get to our destination, so we are going to Sarah's parents' house, their basement. Actually, no. Janji's in the basement. We're gonna stay for 2 weeks before we actually move into our new place. That there's an overlap of we're our lease is ending 2 weeks, and then we have to stay with Sarah's parents because our lease won't start until like the first. So for those 2 weeks, we're gonna try to do as many videos because we'll have the time. We're not gonna be packing. We're not gonna be working.
Yeah, we'll just be chilling. So
yeah, we are gonna watch the Olympics from Sarah's parents' house. So.
Might be on a little potato.
I know she has her little TV from when she was in high school. Okay, questions, comments down below. What did you guys think? Tell me if you need anything.
Keep that in. Did you really just say, tell me if you need anything?
I always say that to my mom.
Do you guys need a glass of water?
Okay, talk to you guys later. Have a good night.
Bye.
Bye.